All right. The 270 terminal ascent went further than the 7 PRC terminal ascent. I'm gonna do the second to last one. We're gonna do Hornady CX bullet. So you can see our styrofoam plates behind the bone is just getting less and less because it's just getting shredded after going through this bone like it would in a normal, like a it would when it goes through an animal. Not much carnage going through the hide. So I think this is actually pretty accurate of what you would see in an elk. But yeah, this is supposed to be the heart and lungs, and we've hit it every time with the 270 and 7 PRC with the terminal ascent and EDLDX. Now let's try the Hornady CX bullet. Going back to the 7 PRC. So this is Hornady's full copper monolithic bullet. And if I am to predict, this one should go the furthest. And hopefully I'm on target. I know these don't, I had like a 3-inch group when I shot these. So, should be able to hit the target, but yeah, I'm just gonna go center of mass on that front plate. And hopefully, if I don't get it on this one, we're gonna go like 50 yards and do it, which will skew the results, but difference between 50 and 100 yards is actually not that much. But anyway, let's throw this down there. Good. Full saltwater fly. We have a dead elk. A little bit less carnage, I don't know. So you can see I hit right next to all the others. See what? Still very small exit on the hide medium. See how it did through the bone. The exit of the bone went through the water jug, and then this is where we're at. Let's see what went the furthest. That water jug is pieces as expected. All right, well, we can see right there, as expected, it went the furthest. I love these mono bullets, how pretty they look after they've been shot. There we go. That is pretty, that's perfect. Mono bullets are king of penetration. Let's go back to in the middle. We can see how much further it went. So the king so far is the 270 win, which would be this one. And it went to about right here. And so this went, and I'm just going to the final tear of the pieces of paper. So the final tear is there. So that is a good 2 inches of paper. So the monolithic bullet, as expected, went 2 inches further than the 270 wind terminal ascent. Stop. We'll see how the 270 Nosler Partition bullet does. So, yep, doing good.
We're off to the last one,
2780 Nosler Partition. Let's see this one fly. This was my favorite bullet until the terminal ascent. So it'll be interesting to see how it compares to the terminal ascent. Dead elk. All right, Layla, you ready to go see the carnage of our last shot with the Nosler Partition? Yeah, let's go check it out. This was a lot of fun. I know this test isn't perfect because I've been using the same medium for all the shots. But this was a lot of fun. We'll see how this last one turns out, but so far everything's kind of made sense to me the way that the performance was. So I don't think it's a bad test. Go ahead and let me know how you do the test different. And if I, you know, get enough subscribers, I'll stop doing stuff just for my entertainment and maybe cater more towards what everybody is wanting to see. So, all right, let's see how this looks. All right, let's see where we hit. First off, well, you can see that was a pretty good entrance hole to the backstop. Ooh, shoot, I barely hit it. Don't know how well my gun is sighted in. Let's see, hopefully I hit this. It does look like I hit it. Yep, I hit it, so that's good. And I hit the water, so that's good. So I don't think we're having a false inconclusive test here. Oh yeah, let's not lose my bullets. We got the 270 terminal ascent and the CX bullet right here. Ooh, I really like that entrance hole. Did I? Oh, I put this backwards. Dang it, we're gonna have to do some math to see which one penetrates the furthest. Wow, this is deep. Did it go through? Okay, it didn't go through. There's the bullet. Yeah, look at that. That's beautiful. Got just as expected, right where the copper kind of goes through the middle of the bullet, that's where it stopped expanding. So, got our three of the four of the types of bolts we have. I'll go grab the ELDX, but you can see Nosler Partition, the CX, and the terminal ascent right there. Now let's try to figure out how deep it penetrated compared to the others. A little more than half. So here's how much the Nosler Partition went, a little more than half. And then this way we can figure out where the 270 went, because the CX went the furthest. So that's the CX right there. All right, 270 terminal ascent right here. So this is the 270 terminal ascent, a little more than half. So the 270 terminal ascent and the 270 PRC, sorry, and the 270 Nosler Partition went about the same distance in penetration. So, all right, time to clean this mess up. Another popular thing to shoot is ballistics gel. And I think that has its place. But I think the one thing with ballistics gel is it's just one material. And elk or deer, antelope, they have all different types of material. You got lungs, you got bones, you got sinew, you got hide, you got hair, fur, dirt. And so that's why I came up with this test, is it had the plate stack, like hard things like hide and bone, and then you had the water that acted like your internal organs, and then the plates at the back to, you know, catch the bullet, but also could act like some more bones and hide and tendons. So anyway, that was a lot of fun. I'd like to do it again. So here are the 5 bullets that I shot. Second to last one I shot was the Hornady CX bullet, and as expected, this one went the furthest by far. It was, I want to say, a few inches further than anything else. So, and I do have my paper here that has all of the entrance holes of the backstop. And I like this because it shows how much devastation was happening. So you can see the 7 PRC ELDX hole is just massive. And you know, that's why it didn't go quite as far. And then 7 PRC terminal set kind of penciled hole through, and you can see that's largely because all the petals were shedded, probably in the water. And then this is kind of inconclusive, but we could, from the results of the others, gather what happened. The 270 terminal scent's a little wider because it didn't shed the petals like it did in the 7 PRC, and that went further. And then the CX bullet is a little inconclusive because it kind of overlaps with the 270, but it kind of penciled through there, being that the petals were kind of flattened down. So, and then my final shot was the Nosler Partition 270 bullet, and I really think this is cool how this expanded. But like the same thing as the terminal ascent, the petals kind of folded down. And I made a mistake and actually shot on the back side of this one, so these results are a little inconclusive as well. But you can see that that is the entrance hole, which is pretty devastating as well. So these results for there's the bullet actually held together.